go back further than that. Let's go back to 4 years. Four. My daughter took dance. And I remember being at the recital, and I remember thinking, I may want to do that. I like to dance. I think I want to take dance. Thinking about it, and I mentioned it to my daughter and wife. Brooke and my daughter were like, won't you take it? And so I thought about it, and let me tell you, I was nervous as all get out. You're a 40-something year old man, and you're thinking about wanting to take tap and jazz, and the number one thing you're thinking about is what in the world am I going to tell everybody around here as to why I decided I want to take tap and jazz? You got to get over that, because it doesn't matter what anybody thinks. If you want to do something, just do it. If you want to take dance, if you want to take tap, jazz, ballet, if you want to pick up ceramics or painting, or if you ever always wanted to play the piano, if you wanted to learn the guitar, do it. Just do it. If you want to start that garden, if you want to raise chickens, if you always wanted to start a little farm or a homestead, you see where I'm going with this? Just do it. Just dance. You know why? Because it does not matter, because we got one shot at life, and that's it. So we might as well dance while we're here. So I decided I'm taking dance, and I'm going to dance. So I went in pretty darn confident, let me tell you. I thought this was going to be fairly easy to some degree, and I was going to pick it up just like that, and it was going to be fun, I was going to enjoy it. And it was the total opposite. It was hard, way harder than I ever imagined. That first month of dance, I wanted to quit, and I was this close from quitting. Thank goodness I didn't, because I stuck through it. I practiced. I'd go upstairs in the upstairs bedroom, push my bed out of the way, download the songs that we were doing on my phone, and then I would just do it, the dance over and over and over and over. And I figured it out, and I enjoyed it. I loved it. And so this is year three. I'm in year three. This was the third year of the dance recital. I didn't record anything because honestly did not plan on doing this video. So there's not much footage behind the scenes of practicing and what we go through and all that. But the friendships, I love my dance family, and it's like a little group of friends, and we all got each other's back. So here it is, the two dances. We have tap and jazz. The jazz routine this year, for some reason, the day of the recital, and everybody, you're always nervous. It doesn't matter who you are, how many times you've done this, or how old you are. When you get on stage, you're gonna be nervous. So, but this year, for some reason, I was way more nervous than I typically am. And so you get on stage, and it's pitch black dark when you're on stage waiting for the curtains to open. And we're lined up, and we're in this little group. We're in three rows, and I'm on the front row, and it's Craig, Rachel, the instructor, the teacher, the owner, and then me. And it's pitch black dark, and when you're back there, it's like it lasts an eternity, just forever before that curtain opens. And so I'm going through the dance in my head, and then it goes blank. I've forgotten the dance. So I'm kind of panicking a little bit here, and so I went over to lean down and tell Rachel, I have forgotten the dance. And as that's going through my mind, the curtains open and the lights come on.
Yeah.
tap routine I was way more confident in. I have no idea why. I wasn't near as nervous in that tap routine at all. I don't know why, I just wasn't. Tap routine comes up and we dance on stage and then this.